waste all their time doing good. How could you make any money from that?
Maybe she owns a piece of the mission.
Yeah.
Hey, Benny Stiles.
Hi, the horse. How are you?
Okay, okay.
You know Nasty Nasty Johnson?
Yeah, how goes it?
Oh, Nasty Nasty, thank you.
Tell me, what about Nathan Detroit? Has he found a place for his cracking?
We don't know yet.
He doesn't.
You're still trying to find a place.
Well, tell him I'm loading and looking for action. I just acquired 5,000 potatoes.
$5,000?
Where did you acquire it?
I collected the reward of my father.
Everybody's looking for action. Making a better find a place.
Why, Lieutenant Brennan? This is Sergeant. This is Lieutenant Brennan of the New York Police Department.
A pleasure.
Any of you guys see Nathan Detroit?
Which Nathan Detroit is that?
I mean the Nathan Detroit that's been running a floating captain and getting away with it by moving it to a different place every night.
Why are you telling us this, Your Honor?
I'm telling you because I know that you two bums work for Detroit, rustling up customers for his crap game.
We do?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, you can tell him for me. I know that right now he's running around trying to find a spot. Well, nobody's going to give him a spot because they all know that Brannigan is breathing down their necks.
Fellas, fellas.
Hi, Nathan.
Fellas, I am in real trouble. That lousy fella.
Something wrong, Mr. Detroit?
Oh, hello, Lieutenant. I hope you did not think I was talking about you. You're all lousy relics.
Detroit, I've just been talking to your colleagues about your cap game. I imagine you're having a little trouble finding a place.
Well, the heat is on, as you must know from the fact that you now have to live on your salary.
Did you find a place?
What does that come out for me? What am I, a sex maniac? I'm meeting on the crap game for the convenience of those who want to lack. In return for which, I take a small cut. Is that a crime?
Nathan, did you find a place?
Did you find a place for the game?
Did I find a place? Did I find a place? Yes, I have found a place. We are holding the crap game tomorrow night on the top of Mount Everest. I have tried all the regular places, the back of the cigar store, the funeral park.
You said once that there might be a chance for the Biltmore Garage.
I have went to the Biltmore Garage, spoke to Joey Biltmore himself. He said he might take the chance and he left me some place. If I give him $1,000.
$1,000?
In cash, he will not take my marker.
Your marker's no good, huh?
What do you mean my marker's as good as cash? Only Joey Biltmore has cash. It does not seem possible, me without a livelihood. Why, I've been on the club game ever since I was a juvenile delinquent.
Nathan, can't you do something?
What can I do? I am broke. I could not even buy Adelaide a present today. And do you know what today is? It is mine and Adelaide's 14th anniversary.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah. We've been engaged for 14 years.
Nathan, concentrate on the game. It's hard to be here with my place. The Greek's in town.
Brandy bottle babies!
I know, I can make a fortune, but where can I have the game?
The Biltmore Garage wants a grand,
but we ain't got a grand on hand.
And they're now gonna lock on the door of the gym at Public School 84. There's a stock room behind McCluskey Farm,
but Mrs. McCluskey ain't a good scout.
And things being how they are, the back of the police station is out.
So the Biltmore Garage is the spot, but the $1,000 we ain't got. Why is it no reliable name?
Name, they,
would not take penicillin and check that Betty's temperature would not go to 104.
Did it?
Did it. He is so lucky when 106. Go to Sky.
Maybe you can borrow $1,000 to Sky.
No, not Sky. With him, that kind of money, it's not lending money. It is better money. So why don't I bet him? Why will I bet Sky Masterson $1,000 or something?
You would bet with Sky Masterson?
I am not scared. I am perfectly willing to take a risk. Provided I can figure out a bet which I know I cannot lose. He likes crazy bets like which lump of sugar will fly today. Or how far I can kick a bit of cheesecake. Cheesecake! Benny, run over to Minnie's restaurant and ask me how much food you sold yesterday and how much cheesecake.
How much cheesecake? How much food? What do you want to know that for?
Just find out. Oh, here comes Ali. She finds out for the club game. She will never step on me again. Go on, beat it. Adelaide Pigeon.
Nathan, darling. Mwah. Okay, if you go ahead, I'll see you later.
Cheers, Ali.
We gotta get right back to the hot box in 10 minutes.
I still need us.
Yeah, it's that slave driver, Charlie. He's been working us all day. Finally, I said, look, Charlie, I gotta get out of here and get something to eat. And he said, you don't want to eat. You just want to sneak out and eat that cheap farm place in Detroit.
So what did you tell him?
Oh, I told him. I said, I'll meet whoever I want.
Don't you not upset yourself? How is it cold?
Oh, it's much better, thanks. Nathan, happy anniversary.
A present for me?
I hope you like it.
Oh, it's a belt.
Read the card.
Sugar is sweet and so is Jen, so put this belt around your belly. About your present. I was going to get you a diamond wristwatch with a gold band and 2 rubies on the side.
Oh, Nathan, you shouldn't have.
It's okay, I didn't. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I kind of like it when you forget to give me presents. It makes me feel like we're married.
Do not worry, honey. One of these days we are going to be in the money and you'll have more mink than a mink.
Nathan, I can do without anything, just as long as you don't start running the crap game again.
The crap game went upset, thought.
1,200 cheesecake and 1,500 strudel.
Huh? Yesterday, Mindy sold 1,200 cheesecake and 1,500 strudel.
More strudel and cheesecake? That is great. That is my bet.
Nathan, what is this?
Nothing, honey, nothing.
Hey, any news yet?
Not yet, Harry. I will let you know later.
Okay, Trudge.
And what was that about?
His wife's had a baby.
And why is he asking you?
He is nervous that he's his first wife. Look, Adelaide, I am expecting this fellow, and I know you must be hungry.
Are you trying to get rid of me, Nathan?
No, of course not. I just don't want your sandwich to get soggy. Fellas, take a look to the drugstore.
Why, Nathan, you're so thoughtful. You did the sweetest price in Dubai.
Hey, Masterson.
Nathan, you old promoter, how are you?
Fine. You look great.
Feel great. 2 wonderful weeks out west of Nevada. Great place. With beautiful scenery, helpful climate, and I beat them all for 50 G's at blackjack.
50 G's? Gonna be in town long?
No, I'll fly into Havana tomorrow.
Havana?
Yeah, there's a lot of action down there. Say, why don't you come with me?
No, I got a lot of things to do. Meantime, could we not jump over to Minnie's for a cheesecake? They sell a lot of cheesecake.
No, I'm not hungry. Tell me, how's Adelaide?
Oh, fine, still dancing at the hot box.
Suppose you'll be getting married soon.
Well, we all gotta go sooner or later.
No, Nathan, guys like us, we can fight it. We know that as beautiful as the Dallas company may be, she'll always take 2nd place to aces back to back.
Yeah. Oh, tell me, are you hungry yet? Could we not jump over to Minnie's for a cheesecake or strudel or something?
No, I think I'll go and get the later sauce.
But you will admit that Minnie's cheesecake is the greatest in the country.
Yes, I'm quite partial to Minnie's cheesecake.
And yet, there are others who prefer Minnie's strudel. Our pan, which do you think sells most of? The strudel or the cheesecake?
Well, I've never given much thought, but if everybody's like what I am, I'd say Minnie sells more cheesecake than strudel.
You want a bet?
Huh?
You want a bet?
Why, Nathan, I didn't take you to be the betting man. I always thought you took your percentage off the top.
Well, for all time's sake, I thought I'd give you a little action. I will bet you $1,000 that yesterday Minnie sold more strudel than cheesecake.
Nathan, let me tell you a little story.
Oh.
When I was a young man about to go into the world, my father says to me a very important thing. And he says to me like this. Sir, the old guy says, seeing as I'm not able to bankroll you to a very large start, since I've no potatoes to give you, I'm going to stake you in some very valuable advice. One of these days, a man's going to come up to you with a brand new deck of cards, with the seal not yet broken. And that man's going to claim he can make the jack of spades jump out of the deck and squirt cider in your ear. Now, son, do not bet this man, for as sure as you stand there, you're going to wind up with an ear full of cider. Now, Nathan, I do not claim that you've been clocking Mindy's cheese.
You don't think that, dear.
But if you're still looking for some action, I will bet you the same $1,000 that you do not know the color of the necktie you have on. Well, no bet.
Oh, blue, what a crazy color.
Nathan, you took Adelaide to the drugstore.
Do not bother me.
How are you, Scott?
Good. How was the wheel post?
Not bad.
Not so bad, thank you. Nathan, we took Adelaide to the drugstore and she said we could be sure to pick her up after the show at the hot box and don't be late.
Yes, dear.
Oh, yes, dear. Nathan, that's the husband talk if ever I heard it. You're trapped. And that lady had the kind of doll which is most difficult to unload.
Maybe I do not want to load Adelaide. I love her. Besides, the guy needs a doll. When a guy walks in the restaurant, it is nice that there's a doll behind him. A doll is a necessity.
I'm not putting a rap on dolls. I just say they should be around when you need them. They're easy to find.
Not dolls like Adelaide.
But figure and wait for age, all dolls are the same.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Then how come you have not got one? How come you are going alone to Havana without one?
I like the travel light, but if I wish to take a doll to Havana, there's a large assortment available.
Not real high-class dolls.
Any doll, you name
her. Any doll, I name her. Will you bet on that? Will you bet $1,000 if you cannot take a doll to Havana tomorrow?
You got a bet!
I name
her.
We look after each other.
And I suppose if one of you goes someplace, the other falls?
Of course.
Of course.
It is sacrificing yourself for others. Stay here in this place.
Do you go any place else? Travel or something?
I'd like to go to Africa.
That's a bit far. But there's a lot of wonderful places just a few hours from New York. By plane. Ever been in a plane?
No.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Here's another pamphlet that I think you should read.
You know, I'm going to need a lot of personal help. You see, my heart is as black as 2 feet down a wolf's gullet.
I'll be speaking at the Thursday night family.
I'm going to need private lessons. Say, why don't we have dinner or something?
I think not, Mr. Masterson.
Sorry, just blossoming under the warmth of your kindness. Hey, that's wrong.
What's wrong?
That's not Proverbs, it's Isaiah.
It's Proverbs.
Sorry, there is no peace in little wicked. It's Isaiah, chapter 57, verse 21.
Isaiah.
There are two things been in every hotel room across the country. Sky Masterson and the Gideon Bible. I must have read the book a good 10 or 12 times.
You've read the Bible 12 times?
What's wrong with the Bible? You see, in my line of work, the strangest information frequently comes in handy. I once won 5 G's on a triple bet on Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Tell me, Masterson, why are you here?
I told you, I'm a sinner.
You're lying.
Well, lying's a sin. I'm a big sinner, and if you get me, it's 8 to 5 years old, the others will follow. You need sinners, don't you?
We're managing.
Look, let's be honest, the mission is laying an egg. I bet you can fill this place with sinners.
I don't bet.
Well, let me make a proposition. When did you say this big meeting of yours is? Thursday. I guarantee to fill this place with 1 dozen more genuine sinners. What's more, we'll make sure they sit still and listen to you.
And what's mine to the bargain?
Have dinner with me.
Why do you want to have dinner with me?
I'm hungry.
Here. What's this?
Sky Masterson's marker for 12 or more sinners. If you don't think it's good, ask anybody in town. I owe you 12 or more sinners. I'll pick you up at noon tomorrow for dinner.
At noon?
It'll take us some time to get there.
To get where?
To my favorite restaurant.
Where is that?
El Cafe Cabana Havana.
El Cafe Cabana Havana?
Where do you want to eat?
Havana?
Look, the plane was... Between will get us then $5 and back and stay night. The food's great.
I now realize, Mr. Gambler, when you were describing the blackness of your heart, you didn't do yourself justice.
And I now realize, Sister Sarah, that no matter how beautiful a sergeant is, she is still a sergeant.
Please go away.
Why don't you change your pitch, Sarge? Come to the mission one and all. Except, guys, I hate guys.
I don't hate anybody.
Except me. Well, I'm relieved to know that's just me personally. I know all guys in general. And that somewhere out in the world there might be a guy that might appeal to the sergeant. I wonder what that guy will be like.
He will not be a gambler.
I'm not interested in what he will not be. I'm interested in what he will be.
Don't worry, I'll know.
Take a chance. chemistry.
Chemistry?
Yeah, chemistry. Suddenly,
my dough in advance.
Joey, you've known me a long time. That's why I wanted in advance.
Listen, I can't talk to them. I've got to meet Ali at the hot box. Just one last thing. Can I tell the boys how the game's going to be your place?
Now do I get my dough?
Okay, I'll have it. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I hope you get stabbed in the stew, Baker.
You too.
Starting with now.
What about your mother?
Oh, well, Nathan, this is something I haven't told you before, but my mother, back in Rhode Island, she thinks we're married already.
Why would she think a thing like that?
I couldn't be engaged for 40 years, could I? People don't do that in Rhode Island. They all get married.
Then why such a small state?
Oh, anyway, I wrote her I was married.
You did, huh?
After about 2 years.
What after about 2 years?
We had a baby.
You told your mother we had a baby?
I had to, Nathan. Mother wouldn't have understood if we hadn't.
What type of baby is it?
It was a boy. I named him after you, Nathan.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And where is Nathan Jr. supposed to be now?
Oh, he's in boarding school. I won't want him in the football game last Saturday.
I wish you had a ballot.
But Nathan, that's not all, Nathan.
Do not tell me he has not a sister.
All those years, Mother believes in big families.
Just give me the grand total.
Why?
Your mother was a glutton for punishment.
But now we're getting married, and it won't be a lie anymore.
Allie, how can you do such a thing to a nice old boy like your mother?
But Nathan, you don't even know my mother.
But I'll be meeting her soon. What I tell her? What I tell her to give her 5 kids? Lose them in a poker game? Allie, what are we going to do?
We could get married.
But marriage is not something you jump into like it was a kettle of fish. We are not ready.
I'm ready, Nathan. Why do you think I got this wax? Nathan!
Tomorrow.
It says here, the
just followed Miss Sarah, and you should have seen her. She gave him a look that would have cooled off a losing many times.
Great, just so he don't send the doll to Havana.
Havana, he could not take that dame across the street. Where's Nick? Neurosar lined up the gate.
I don't know. Probably with Adelaide. She's mad at him again.
Yeah, Miss Adelaide. She's always trying to take his mind upon his work.
Yeah, it's too bad that a smart businessman like Nick has to go and fall in love with his own fiance.
Benny, that is his weakness. And we should be towered, for I am told it is a worldwide weakness. Look! What's Pain in the Long Sea? I'll tell you what's Pain in the Long Sea. A picture by the Minnesota man, so in love with Mississippi girl, and he sacrifices everything that moves all the way to the Long Sea. That's what's Pain in the Long Sea.
What's in the day news? I'll tell you what's in the day news. Story about a guy who fought his wife this small ruby with what otherwise would have been his union dues. That's what's in the day news.
What's happening all over? I'll tell you what's happening all over. Guy sent home by a television set that wants it to be something of a rover. That's what's happening all over. Love is the thing that has linked them, and it looks like Nathan's just another victim. Yes, sir! When you see a guy reach for stars in the sky, you can bet that it's rude for some time.
My name is Sky Masterson, Formerson.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I wish to protest to the closing of this mission. I believe Sister Sarah can be a big success here.
I'm glad to hear you say that, but I'm not so certain.
Doll, get your ten. I make a suggestion. Why don't you come to the Big Bean tomorrow night and see for yourself? Don't you think that'll be a good idea?
Well, if I thought the mission had a chance. General, I personally guarantee you at least one dozen genuine sinners.
Wouldn't it be great if we could get married?
sir?
You could have blurred, you could have looked.
What?
You could drive upstage. What's the name of that place?
Alcatraz.
No, no! Nathan, Buffalo, they invite you right away. They don't ask you for a blood test.
Ain't that unhealthy? Nathan, that's a great idea. Although, I'll let you my getaway car. Bye.
Oh, Nathan, let's do it.
Well, what the hell?
And Matt, congratulations too, Nathan. I only hope there's nothing in heredity.
Oh, Nathan, I've got so many things to do before you look. Will you paint the hot box tomorrow night?
I'll be all dressed up in one of your old things.
Oh, Nathan, I'm so happy. I ought to wire my mother only. Why do I wire her?
Send her a telegram and date it back.
No, no, no. I ought to wait to have 5 children. It won't take us long.
Nathan, you're indeed a lucky fellow. Most beautiful doll indeed.
Tell me, how long do you know the doll?
14 years.
Let's shoot crap.
You had better find a place.
How come? Wait for Sky's not come yet.
Maybe you woke up. Maybe he took the doll to Havana.
He could have. Could he? She can have a gun.
Sounds like a million laughs. Thank you. I've never Thank you.
see Miss Adelaide?
Huh?
I bring for her a message from Nathan. I wish Nathan would bring his own messages.
Where is Nathan? What is the message?
It's like this. Nathan's aunt in Pittsburgh has been suddenly taken ill with
a rare tropical disease.
Yeah, that's not bad. Anyway, Nathan has to...
Where is Nathan?
The crap game's still going on.
Since last night?
Big Julie, being a large loser, does not wish the game to terminate. In fact, he is most insistent. So, we find another place, the game goes on.
Where is the game?
Are you looking for some action?
No, I'm leaving town tonight, but I'd like to talk to some of the guys. You see, actually, I sort of give my marker to somebody. Like,
well, I'll meet you outside.
What about Nathan's message?
Oh, Miss Adelaide. Nathan is in Pittsburgh with a rare tropical aunt.
What?
Come on!
You know Nathan, why does it surprise you?
But he promised to change.
Change? Why is it when you dolls get a guy you like, you take him straight in front of the races?
What about you, Matt? Why can't he marry the wife he'll do? Have a home with wallpaper and bookends?
No, Miss Adelaide.
What do you mean, no?
Guys like Nathan are trying, and yes, Guy Masterson, we don't belong to a life like that. But so when you dolls get mixed up with guys like us, it's no good. No good. See you in a couple of months.
Where are you going?
Oh, I don't know. Las Vegas, maybe. I've got a ticket on a late flight.
Will you see Nathan before you go?
Maybe.
Tell him I never want to speak to him again. And have him call me here.
Why don't you get yourself another guy?
I can. I love Nathan. Wait till you fall for someone. You'll see.
Yes.
Yeah. In other words, from sitting alone at a table reserved for two, a place that can be bound the blue. You can bundle her up in woolies, and I mean the warmest friend. You can wrap her in sweat and coats till it's more than a friend can stand. If you still get the feeling she's naked from looking at her left hand, a place that
Forget these sort of things.
You hold my mark for 12 or more sinners tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Masterson, but I'd rather you forgot about it.
I can't vouch for Margaret.
Last night, the mission was filled with your friends. Let us say we're even.
If you don't pay up on that marker, I'll tell the whole town you're a dirty Welsher.
Nice! Where's the gate?
It's about 10 minutes from here.
Which way?
This way.
Snake eyes lose.
Chicago,
There was nothing you could do to me that would not cheer me up.
Here they are.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Well,
where's your blood?
Imagine.
Not at the moment. I just want to talk to some of you guys.
We ain't talking. We're shooting crap.
I'm asking for only 1 minute.
I told you. We're shooting crap.
To do Miss Sarah Brown's mission.
Say, who is this guy?
Well, I told him that. Took a mission down to her bed.
Oh, I get it. Look, fella. Why don't you go back and pray to tomato? As long as the action around here.
Are you still looking for some action? Would you like to make a small wager on a proposition?
What's the proposition?
Am I right-handed or left-handed?
Now how am I supposed to know something like that?
I'll give you a little clue. Here for the Signor's box. Look, you guys. Tonight, Miss Sarah Brown's mission on 409 West 49th Street beholds a midnight prayer. Now, I promised I'd deliver them some sinners. And when it comes to sinning, most of you guys are high up there amongst the paint cards.
I don't know which, no evening, no hell you do,
Joy. Look, if you won't do this a favor to me, do this a favor to yourself. I guarantee the air in the mission smells a whole lot cleaner than down here. And just maybe you guys might learn something else and the odds will make it fall the hard way.
You read the Bible too much.
So what? The Bible don't read as lightly as the scratches, but it's at least twice as accurate. Well, I tried. See you later, Nicky.
Well, Sky, about the metal business. I regret I temporarily do not have the dough to pay you.
You don't have to pay me.
You won. But I thought it was Sarah to have left. You thought wrong. Get up here, Julie. I do not have the dough to order you again. This time, with my own dice.
Nothing, Julie. Well, those dice can make a pastor save his soul.
What did you say?
I say with those dice, you can't make a pass to save his soul.
But maybe I can make one to save yours. And yours, and his. I'll throw you $1,000 against your soul. 1,000 cash against the marker for your soul. Is it okay?
Yes. Let me get this. If you lose, we get $1,000, but if you win, we gotta show up the mission dollars, Gabber.
If I win, you guys show up the save soul mission. One meeting.
Okay, by me.
By me too.
Yeah!
How about you, Nick? $1,000 against your soul?
Me, I do not even know if I have a soul.
Come on, someplace.
Benny, how do you spell soul?
S.
Oh. Right, put down your markers, Molly. Give me the dice. And give me room.
Come on! Quit stalling! Roll!
It was a mess, guy, clean chicken.
You saw me roll for 100 G's? Well, got a little more to go, Ryan, on this one. They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You'll run this date with me. The pickings have been lush. And yet before this evening is over, you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners, you might refuse to stay, and so the best that I can do is pray. Luck to your lady tonight, luck to your lady tonight, luck to you've never been a lady to begin with, luck to your lady tonight. Luck, let a gentleman see. How nice is it to be?
publish anything that will cause me no little embarrassment. I'm sure you do not wish to cause me embarrassment.
Okay, okay. But if it ever gets back in this gargle that I went for brevity, no decent person will talk to me.
Adelaide!
Oh, what a coincidence!
Adelaide, did I speak to you about tonight? I hope you ain't sore about it.
Please, let us not have a vulgar scene. After all, we are civilized human beings, and we do not have to conduct ourselves like a slob.
Adelaide, what is this with my dog?
Your dog, please! If that weren't so amusing, one would laugh at it!
Sweetheart, baby, how can you carry on like this over one loud elephant?
It's no use, Nathan. I succeeded in you not being able to upset me anymore. I've got you completely out of my... Oh, Nathan!
It's irrelevant to that to me again. I can understand it. We will get married. We will have our own home. We'll have a little house with a green fence just like the Whitney colours.
Oh, Nathan, we gotta do it soon. I had another letter off my mother asking a lot of questions. She put one in for you.
A letter for me from your mother? Wow. Dear son Nathan, this is my first letter to you, although you've now been married to my daughter for 12 years now. But I feel as though I know you from Adelaide's letters, and in my mind's eye, I can see you as you go down at work each morning at 7. What a responsibility must be to the assistant manager of an A&P. I am now the manager.
I was going to promote you for Christmas.
I know how hard you have to work to take care of Adelaide and the family. The 5 children, and the one that's on the way.
Mother wanted me to visit her. I had to tell her that.
Does she not know I can have 6 kids and want to pay me to attend an A&P? I am very proud to have you as a son-in-law. You are a good man, and I know you will always take care of Adelaide. I feel like a hero.
Nathan, darling, we can still make everything all right. Look, it isn't even midnight yet. 12:05. Nathan, let's see what's going on now.
Okay, Alex.
No!
No, I can't.
Why not?
Come on, you'll be late. Come
Nathan,
on.
Why can't you look right now?
Well, you see, I gotta go to this premiere.
Oh, this is the biggest lie you ever told me!
What can you do?
Dutchess fast.
General, I know what's wrong. I'm wrong. I've spoken to these people day after day, but my words haven't been true. I think...
Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome.
Is everybody here?
Yeah.
Where's Nathan Detroit?
Present.
Here you are, Miss Sarah. What does the more sorted citizens? I'm sorry I didn't have time to clean them up for you.
Won't you, ladies and gentlemen, please sit down?
That's all right, we'll stand, thanks.
Sit down, all of you!
I would like to welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, to the Save a Soul mission.
Yeah. Anyone else?
nicely, nicely chancing. Brother, nicely, nicely chancing.
Get up, you fat water buffalo!
Well, it happened to me kind of funny. Like a dream. Yeah, that's in a dream.
I dreamed last night I got on the boat to heaven, and by some chance I had brought my dice along, and there I stood, and I hollered, "Someone paid me." But the passengers, they know I'm wrong.
Follow the fold.
Yeah.
was gold. Where's the wedding?
Holy smoke.
What's the matter?
I forgot I got a place for the wedding.
Oh, Nathan!
How about the billboard garage?
Brothers and sisters, life is one big crap game with a double.
Certainly I married Brother Masterson and Sister Sarah. Glad to do the same for you.
Congratulations, I'll lay 8 to 5, you'd be very happy.